Hey, aloha and good evening, folks. Thank you for joining us tonight. We want to welcome everyone in for this very special presentation that we have, but it's not just a presentation, it really is a discussion. We know that there has been quite a bit of interest. If you've been out into the Kapolei, the Pearl City, Waipahu area, maybe Aiea, there's a good chance that you have seen the trains actually up on the guideway moving eastbound or westbound. Perhaps you've even seen more than just one train. You've possibly seen two or three trains up at the same time. So we wanted to have this presentation tonight to let you know as much as we can about what is going on right now. It is called dynamic train testing, and this is why we're having the meeting, because we know that there is a great deal of interest in that. Now, as we said with the presentation, we're going to have a presentation with our experts, going to last around 30 minutes or so, and then it's really important for you folks to know that we want this to be a sort of question and answer session. Hey, before we go any further, let me introduce myself. My name is Jai Cunningham. I work with the Honolulu Authority for Rapid Transportation, and let me let you know exactly how you can send in your questions. So if you're watching us right now on Facebook, very easy to submit questions, and we've already had some questions that have been sent in. You just simply go down to the comment section and put your question in there. We have folks who are monitoring. Now, just to let you know how things are going to work throughout the evening, we are in a conference room. So I'm wearing a mask because we are practicing social distancing. And so a couple of presenters you will see will have masks on. Some of the presenters will not, but just know this, those presenters are in their office without anyone in there. So that's why they're not wearing masks. So we just want to make sure that you know that we are definitely sensitive to COVID-19 and what is happening. So besides the Facebook questions in the comment section that we have people monitoring, you can also email us any questions that you might have. It's very easy, info@honolulutransit.org. So those are the two ways you can do it. And please, if you have a question, we are really interested in hearing from you. As we said, we've already had a couple of questions submitted to us that are very good questions. And this is your chance to talk with some of the experts when it comes to the train testing and the work that they're doing there. A lot of times it's sort of above your head, so you don't necessarily get a chance to see it, but there are a lot of moving parts, and we have the experts here tonight. So if you do have those questions, we would love for you to submit them. So let's get started. And with that, I want to let you know what the agenda is going to be. We're going to kind of give you an overview of the train testing, what's happening, where it's happening, kind of the who, what, when, where, and why. Then we're going to tell you more about dynamic train testing. Also, we're going to talk about some safety reminders, and then that's our chance, once we have heard from those experts with those three things on the agenda, then it's our chance to answer any questions you may have. Then we would really like to ask a favor of you folks out there who are tuning in, watching us on Facebook live with this presentation. We would love for you to take our survey. It's really important for us to know what's happening in the community. This is your train that is being built. It's your system that's being built. So your opinion, your thoughts are very critical to us here at the Honolulu Authority for Rapid Transportation. And then we want to know and let you know some of the things that we're doing in the community, businesses as well as just residential, that sort of thing. Let you know how we are outreaching to you and how you can reach back out to us as well. So to get the program started, to get the presentation started, I want to introduce you to the executive director at HART here, the chief executive officer, and we welcome in Mr. Andrew Robbins. Andy?
Okay, thank you, John. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Well, welcome. Good evening, everyone. It's great to have all of you online to hear this presentation, and we're very excited to present it to you. First, I'd like to represent a couple of special guests that I understand have tuned in. We have a member of the City Council, Council Member-elect Andrea Tupola, I believe is online. So welcome to you and congratulations. And then also another newly elected public official, Representative Sunny Gonadin, I understand, is also on. So welcome to you, Representative-elect. And I also understand that Council Member Brandon Elefante, the chair of the Transportation Committee, for the city council may also be tuning in. So if you are a council member, welcome as well. Always good to have you on board. Okay, so as Jai said, we're going to make this presentation to you today to talk about dynamic train testing. And if we could go to the next slide. This is the a map of the western portion of the rail transit project. You may know that the entire rail transit project is designed to be 20 miles long with 21 stations. And what you are seeing here is the westernmost part of the system from the Kualakai station, which is right in front of the Croc Center in East Kapolei, through Waipahu, through Pearl City, through Pearl Ridge, over to the stadium area where we have the Halava Stadium. So this is the first 10 miles of the 20-mile system. The construction of the guideway and the rail operation center is complete, and we're putting the finishing touches on those first 9 stations that you see on the map. So essentially, all of the construction out west here on these first 10 miles that you've been hearing about for many years now, is we're at the point now where the construction is essentially complete. And we're at the point where we're running trains now. We're actually running trains, testing the trains, testing all of the technology and all of the systems that comprise the rail transit system. And we have a very extensive test program to make sure that everything is functioning the way it's supposed to, everything is working, and it's completely safe. It's only once we are certified to be safe that we can permit passengers on board. So while you see trains running and it looks like it's ready to go, just please understand that we have to go through this extensive test program, but we're getting through that. It's going to continue through the first half of next year. And then we're gonna be very excited to open this first 10 miles to passenger service sometime around the middle of next year. So we're at that point now where we can really look forward to welcoming passengers, the public, to come on board the train and really check it out. So it's exciting times around HART and around the city. Okay, if we go to the next slide, please. So we're gonna talk about dynamic train testing and give you those details, and then take your questions and answers. So as I mentioned, the train testing is taking place on the elevated guideway between the Kualakai station at East Kapolei to the Halava station at Aloha Stadium. You're gonna see multiple trains running, or perhaps you've already seen them running during this test phase, pretty much through now, through the middle of 2021 on a 24/7 basis, pretty much around the clock. And you see 3 shifts of testing that will be going on, starting at 6 in the morning and proceeding all the way to through the evening into the early morning hours, pretty much around the clock. We have a lot of work to do, and we're very anxious to get through it, get it finished, get it safety certified, and get the system ready for passenger service. So this testing gets the system completely prepared for operational readiness status, so that we can get the safety certification and then be ready to turn this 10 miles over to the City Department of Transportation Services, who will then take over, oversee the operations, and launch it for what we call the interim service to welcome passengers on board. We go to the next slide. So we have a team at HART, our public involvement team, that has been out in the community in Waipahu, Pearl City, Aiea, all those communities where the 10 miles runs through, canvassing the community. We've been to more than 1,000 homes, and we put out more than 12,500 pieces of direct mail to businesses and residences, advising everyone of this phase of the project where we're going through the tests. It's a different phase than perhaps everybody has been used to with construction activities. We're happy to be through the construction, and now we're at the point where we're actually running trains. So it's a different period of time in the evolution of this period of this project, and we want to make sure that everybody's aware of what's going on. Okay, so now what I would like to do is to turn the presentation over to Mr. Wei Win, who will run through some of the details of the dynamic train test itself. Okay, Wei, take it away.
Thank you very much, Andy. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Okay, great. After many years of planning, design, construction, the first 10-mile segment of the rail system is currently under the testing phase. And this is the final phase prior to passenger service. You already heard about all of these steps Andy discussed earlier. And personally, having worked on system engineering for more than 30 years, I see this as a great period as we are bringing everything to come together to work as an integrated system. But it's also a very challenging period since any issue we need to be detected very quickly and then resolved, because every single problem can have ripple effect on everything else. And that could cause a serious delay. And that's what we don't want. Now, the system testing phase, it covers a lot of activities under the what we call the verification, testing, and acceptance program. And then the abbreviation for that is VTA. And you probably will hear a lot about VTA. Now, dynamic testing, the topic of our discussion tonight, is one of the key test activities under the VTA program. And you heard about Andy saying a lot about safety certification. And so through testing, safety certification will be obtained prior to passenger service. Now, we structure the dynamic testing here, put together a summary with five different steps. And the first step, when trains first arrive in Honolulu, and then the last step, trial running. And then I will go over this in the following slides. Again, the dynamic testing in this presentation is for the first segment between East Kapolei and Aloha Stadium. Sorry, I did not turn my camera on. Next slide, please. Here we talk about step one and step two. There will be seven trains for interim opening operation. The entire fleet for the rail system at full opening for the 20 miles long system, we will have 20 trains. So finally, we will have all 20 trains arrive in Honolulu later next year. The trains are built and assemble in Pittsburgh, California, prior to delivery on site here in Honolulu. And then after they arrive, they go through the assembly and inspection. And that's in step one. Next step is step two, static and dynamic routine. And as you can see that they, once they assemble, they're taken to onto the guideway. And they will be tested for acceleration and braking performances for a 1 week period. And for each train, it has to go up there and it will take a week to do. And this is the area between Halalani Station and Ho'olai Station, Leeward Community College and West Lock. And then after that, the trains will undergo onboard static and dynamic routine testing of the automated train control system, we call ATC, and the communication equipment for 1 month for each train. And the entire fleet will have to go through this period of testing. And we're happy to report right now all 7 interim opening drains have been completed with step 1 and step 2. Next slide, please. In this step, this is a very critical step because our system here is a fully driverless system. So in this test, the automated drain control ATC system will be tested. This is where all the driverless function and capability of automated drain control are tested. So the picture there you can see is at the operation control center. And right now, all drain movements along the guideway, they are remotely monitored by operators sitting at this facility. So from here, the system operator can make direct announcements and then monitor activities on the drains. And all of these are very critical to driverless system and then public safety. Again, safety is very critical. Also, one major milestone in this step is for us to be able to test multiple drains. And then this is to allow one drain to follow another drain in fully automated mode. And we went through this, we started this process early this year, and I'm happy to report that we have been able to run up to 4 drains right now in multiple drain running mode. So you can see multiple drains operation up there. Again, this is an important step in the safety certification process. There are 3 different types of ATC testing here, along the wayside, on the guideway, on the vehicles, and then at the central control. This process takes about 1 year to complete. Right now, the wayside and the vehicle ATC test are done. We're looking at completion of the central control testing to be done in January next year. So right now, we expect all the ATC tests wayside, central, and then vehicle, everything will be done at that time. Next slide, please. The next step is the system integration dynamic testing. And this is a very critical test of all the testing phase, because if we don't complete this dynamic testing, system integration testing, we will not be able to go into trial run. So there are many different subsystems, and they all need to be integrated together to work as one single system. And then I said earlier, if there's any problem with any subsystem here, it will have a ripple effect on everything else. And we don't want to encounter problems with our testing program because we have a lot of people out there testing. Besides drains, ATC, you can see there's a communications system for voice, data, and video transmission. We also have a traction electrification system with 13 power substations located along the entire 20 miles alignment. For the 10 miles alignment, we're talking about tonight, we have 7 substations. Another function of testing we do here is we test all the alarms on the system, on the vehicles, along the guideway, at all the stations. Now, there are thousands and thousands of alarms on the trains. And then at the station, so when any alarm is triggered, follow-up action is required immediately by the central control operator. And then because this is a driverless system, So all of these alarms are very critical to the system operation and to the safety of passengers. And we're testing all of these alarms right now. The testing is taking place in addition to the mainline. We also test them at the maintenance storage facility, and specifically in the functional section, the area we discussed earlier between LCC and Westlock. Now, this phase will take about 6 months to complete, and we anticipate that this testing phase will be completed in April next year before we go into trial running. The final step of dynamics testing is trial running, and then this is to demonstrate system operational readiness, safety, and security. During this period, we ensure the plans, procedures, training, manuals, everything, all the equipment will be ready in operation as designed. Now, completion of this step, again, is required in order for us to go into to get the safety certification, and then we go into passenger service. This phase right now, we're planning for 3 months from April 2021 to July next year. One thing about the trial running, we will have 5 trains running from 6 a.m. in the morning to 10 p.m. in the evening. And the rest will be used for maintenance and completion of outstanding work and to run additional tests as required. In summary, right now we are in step 3, ATC testing, and step 4, integration testing. And we will go into trial running step 5 in April. That's the date we're planning. All right, next slide, please. Prior to going into trial run, right now Hitachi is running 3 ships, and HART's representatives are together with Hitachi folks every shift. Shift 1 from 6 in the morning to 2 in the afternoon, and then shift 2 from 2 to 10 in the evening, and shift 3 from 10 in the evening to 6 in the morning. And that's for weekdays. On Saturday and Sunday, we're running only 1 shift. And right now, as said earlier, there's no exact schedule for train operation because we are testing various scenarios, and the testing schedule is very dynamic. And between Hitachi and HART, we maintain communication, constant communication. Every day, we have a meeting every week to plan for the following week. And any changes during the day, we keep informing everyone, and we make an adjustment to the schedule accordingly. As far as environmental effect, noise, vibration, light, we don't anticipate any increase beyond the current levels. Regarding road traffic implication, we see this is very minimal since dynamic testing is conducted on the dedicated right of way. And the same thing with public safety concerns, all dynamic testing is conducted in on the guideway and at the maintenance storage facility. And then one thing I said earlier is everything is in the restricted areas. We continuously monitor everything through our cameras at central control. So that concludes my presentation. Thank you very much. And by the way, those are the pictures of the we call the core system equipment. Very quickly, you'll see the communication equipment, the left-hand side, the upper row there, and then equipment for the traction power in the middle on the top. And then on the right-hand side, there the passenger screen gates, and this is to protect passengers waiting for train arrival. Below, see equipment for the train control at the equipment room at the station. And then there's track equipment there on the right-hand side. Okay, and thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Wee. We appreciate that, again, from Core Systems here at HART. Again, we've already got a number of different questions that have been sent in. And if you have a question, please feel free. There's two different ways. If you're watching us on Facebook right now and you go to the comment section, we have folks who are monitoring that. So just simply enter into the comments what your question is. And then there's another way if you want to simply send an email in, info@honolulutransit.org. So two easy ways to send your questions. We already have some questions, but feel free if you are interested in what you're hearing. You know, you haven't had a chance. Maybe you've seen the trains in the distance, but you're not sure exactly what all goes into it. Well, I think tonight is going to be sort of an eye-opener. So those are the two ways that you can send in questions for us. And now I want to introduce from Hitachi Rail Honolulu, Robert Beadle, and he's going to talk a little bit more about safety reminders. Bob?
Thanks, John. Good evening. Safety reminders, one of the big issues is look ahead, not overhead. When you're driving, just remember to keep your eyes on the road ahead of you, not on the trains above. The trains are here to stay, so you'll have plenty of opportunities over the years to take a future photo or video. Avoid electrical hazards. This is an electric railway. The rail guideway is from East Cap to Aloha Stadium is energized 24/7 and to accommodate the train testing. Please stay safe. Keep off the guideway. Keep away from the stations. Don't trespass. Do not go beyond the secured fences, please. And stay away from the guideway and the rail maintenance and storage facility. And keep out of the construction zones. I know it's been said several times that the construction is mostly complete. There is still a lot of finishing works going on. There's the equipment and personnel at all of the stations working. And it is very, very critical that you do not try to enter the stations. You don't know what's going to happen. And there's a lot of equipment there still. So please be safe. Let us finish our work and enjoy the train and the system when we put it into service for you. Thank you.
Thank you, Bob. We appreciate that. And once again, want to get to those questions. You can send them in to info@honolulutransit.org. We have already gotten a few emails. And then also, if you want on Facebook, just go to the comments section. And that is where you can file your questions. So we look forward to answering those questions, and let's not wait any longer. We already have, as we said, a few questions that have come in. We got a question from a friend of ours that loves this rail system, Moon Pellerin. She says, will it be safe to ride a train that has no driver? Now, I'm not sure who we want to welcome in on that. Maybe Andy, because I know we've talked about this numerous times. Andy, if you don't mind, what makes a driverless system safe? Because I think people just associate the fact that you need a driver for a train to be safe, but you've told me in the past that that's not necessarily the case.
Yes, Di, and thank you for the question. You know, we're at the point in the evolution of technology where driverless trains are actually considered safer than trains with operators because the human element is removed. And automated transit has been around now for more than 50 years. It has an extremely impressive safety record. There's a very sophisticated technology called automated or automatic train control. that has the job of keeping the trains separated and regulated is a subsystem called automated train protection. That's considered a fail-safe system, which means that if there is a failure, it fails in a safe state, trains will stop. And so that technology is well proven. Hitachi has delivered many of these systems before. They're verified, they're validated, and it all goes into making a very safe system.
Thank you, Andy, for answering that. And we got some early questions that came in, and they are very specific. And so that's the good news. So I want to just ask my experts, who we have a number of them on the phone line at different locations. So if you ladies and gentlemen don't mind, if you want to weigh in on a question, we have Bob Beadle here from Hitachi Rail Honolulu. But we also have not just Director Robbins calling us remotely, but we also have other experts as well. So if you don't mind, if you just would say your name, and like with Wee Nguyen, he's with Core Systems, if you could just what department or what your title is, and then feel free to weigh in, because I know we have a number of different experts. So one of the good questions that came in, and this is via Facebook, we've got Paul Kimo McGregor asking, how much progress have you made in burning in the train cars? So I'll turn real quick and look to Bob Beadle here and see if he wants to. They've obviously been testing, and as you guys have heard them say, 24/7. So these vehicles have been seeing a lot of action, but let me have him come up and more address that.
We've been burning in the trains now for over 4 months. We'll continue on until the end of April, when we go into trial running, and then from trial running, there's another 90 days of train burn in at schedule to get ready for the passengers. So each vehicle will have many hours of and miles of under its belt.
Thank you, Bob. Appreciate that. Okay, Mr. McGregor also wanted to know, how much progress have you made in integration of the systems? So I'm not sure who wants to take that, whether it be Bob Good. You know what, Bob, if you don't mind, introduce yourself. This is Bob Good. Bob, if you could, kind of your role here at HART, and then if you don't mind, let us know where you kind of stand and what kind of progress you've made on integration of the systems.
Okay, thank you, Jai. I'm Bob Good, and I'm Senior Project Officer here at HART, and have the responsibility for the testing and integration of the system. And we are probably 75% through our integration test. We have tested the subsystems, and right now we are testing the integration of the systems with one another and with the operational control center. As we showed you the picture, we're doing that integration testing right now. As an example of one of the subsystems, the closed circuit television right now on segment one, we have about 1,200, roughly in that neighborhood of closed circuit televisions around the system. We're checking them for field of view, so that the OCC operators can view all portions of each station. We have an analytics program that looks to make sure if anybody leaves packages or things around, that we sense those. So we're well on our way to testing the integration of the system. And we're running, as we had said before, in automatic operation with four trains. through the 10 miles. So that's all of the testing and the integration of the train with the passenger station interface for stopping. And we're stopping within plus or minus 6 inches of the center line of the door. So again, as Andy mentioned earlier, these automated systems are probably a lot more accurate and safe than any of the manual operations. I would challenge most people with their car to be able to come in to a station or in to a specific area from 55 mile an hour to zero and stop consistently within plus or minus 6 inches of a point. That's where we are right now. And as I say, we're about 75% complete with our integration. We're doing that final stage now with the trains, the wayside, traction power, and operationally out there running and getting ready, as we said, for the trial running, where we'll operate the entire system just as it would in revenue service for the 90-day period. We'll be looking there for not only testing the system, but all the interfaces with the people who are maintaining and operating the system and handling the security around the system. So again, we are moving along reasonably well right now. I hope that answers the question. And if you have any more, I'd be happy to answer them. Thanks, Jai.
Thank you, Bob. We appreciate that. And thanks to Mr. McGregor for those questions. We appreciate that. And I think Bob was able to really answer a couple of more of the different questions as far as the automated train control and as well as the schedule that's oncoming. So we appreciate that. And we appreciate your the knowledge that Mr. Good has given to this project, because he has been in the business a long time. And I mean that with the greatest respect, Mr. Good, a long time, and he really does know his stuff. Okay, we have a question from Ronald Ignacio, and he has written in and says, are you going to fix all the potholes in the parking lot next to Club Ruby's, where a lot of trucks were in and out from 94-819 Farrington Highway, says that our cars are getting damaged? So, Mr. Ignacio, let me real quickly let you know how you can get in touch with us. If you could, email us your information to info@honolulutransit.org. Then we can follow up with our contractor on this issue to address if it is construction related, and then we can move on with that. So again, the email address is info@honolulutransit.org. And so if you could send us your information, we can reach out and get in touch with you. Now, Mr. Ignacio also had a question, and we've been out into this area just recently, in fact. He wants to know, what about all the dust that got into our apartments? Are you guys planning to pay for cleaning it? He says that they live right by the rail station. This is right across from, I don't know if you've been to the new location, but Highway N just moved in literally by the Waipahu Transit Center. So want to let you know this, Mr. Ignacio, regarding any dust issues or damage to your apartment, if you could send us an email, and again, this is at info@honolulutransit.org with contact information, then we will be able to send you information on filing a claim. So again, info@honolulutransit.org. That's the email that you can send that to us. And then also at the end of this, we have a hotline number. If you would rather or feel more comfortable calling the hotline, we can get information from you there via that as well. Okay, another question. This one coming in via email. This is from Susie from info@honolulutransit.org. I'm glad to see safety is important. What will Hitachi do to not trespass into your train yard or guideway to avoid the electrofield third rail? So I know, let me call up Bob Beadle. Bob, if you could. And I know that Hitachi and I know you touched on this a little bit, the safety aspect of that rail yard is critically important to you guys.
Actually, that's true. Safety is the most critical aspect of this whole project. As far as accessing the maintenance and storage facility, that is a locked facility with security gate at the entrance. The fences are wired. There are cameras, as Bob Good mentioned. There are some 400 cameras, CCTV cameras in the maintenance facility yard that activate on motion and activate also if someone tries to breach the perimeter fence. So the yard itself is very secure. The guideway is very secure, so that people cannot just make an untoward access.
Thank you, Bob. We appreciate that. And yes, that is a secure facility that they have out there. So we've had, and this one I want to welcome in once again, our executive director, because I know he's talked about this. So we had someone who sent us a Facebook question, says, my parents are older and I want to know what safety elements are in place at the stations and on the trains to protect passengers in case of any emergencies. Andy, if you don't mind, I know you have talked a great deal about this. Mr. Beadle talking about safety being of utmost importance, and I know you feel exactly the same way.
Right. Well, safety is number one. It always will be in terms of our construction activities, and of course, when we go into operations, safety is number one. There are all kinds of safety features built into the system. There's technology, and then there's also the human element. So on the technology side, as Mr. Good mentioned, we have many closed circuit television cameras that are monitored. We have the video analytics that keep track of packages that might be left somewhere and so forth. So that's one aspect of it. We have emergency telecom, if you will, emergency telephone or intercom panels located on all the station platforms, as well as on board the trains. We have real-time video on board the trains. And, you know, I'm very pleased that the Honolulu Rail Transit System includes what we call platform screen gates on the platforms. For those of you that might be familiar with the New York subway or the BART system in San Francisco, you know that they have open platforms, meaning when the train comes into the station, the train is right there and you have to stand back behind a yellow line. Our system actually has a barrier between the trainway and where you stand as passengers on the platform. They're called platform screen gates. It's like an elevator in a building where the platform screen gate open and close together with the vehicle doors. That's a great safety enhancement. It prevents people from either falling onto the track or somehow landing onto the track. So we're really, really thrilled to have that as part of the Honolulu system.
Thank you, Andy. We appreciate that. We also got a Facebook question in here from Cooney, a guard. Cooney is a Pearl City Neighborhood Board District 21 member, and we appreciate that. And in fact, as part of our outreach, we have a construction team that makes regular visits to those neighborhood boards and when they have those nightly meetings. So it's critical that we have outreach with the neighborhood boards, because you guys really do kind of have a finger on the pulse of your community. And so it really helps us to have that interaction. So Mr. Agard wants to know and says, residents have questions regarding access to the Waiava station. How do pedestrians get from one side of Kamehameha Highway, Pearl Highlands, to the station? How will the parking and bus stops work? So I want to welcome in Ryan Tam real quick. Ryan, if you don't mind, just introduce yourself with heart. And if you could, I think you're best to sort of answer to this. So, Dr. Tam.
Okay. Good evening. Thank you, Jai. Again, my name is Ryan Tam. I'm the Director of Planning, Environmental Compliance, and Sustainable Mobility for HART. I've been on the project here with the city for almost 12 years, so 11 years, 9 months. And So the question in terms of the Wyava Station access. So again, for those of you who aren't familiar, the Wyava or Pearl Highlands Station is located at the Banana Patch. So this is the area just the Makai of Kamehameha Highway, and it's just below the Pearl Highlands Shopping Center. So in order to get to the station, at least in the interim period, HART is actually working with the State of Hawaii Department of Transportation and the Federal Highways Administration, and also the city, to actually build a left turn from Koala Street, from Kamehameha Highway eastbound onto Koala Street. And that project will include a signalized crosswalk. So that'll be the way that you'll get across the westbound Kamehameha Highway from Koala Street. You'll cross over, go onto the median, and then there'll be another crosswalk across the eastbound direction. And so from there, if you've driven by there, you'll see there's a pretty large grade difference, and that's to accommodate, that's because of the flooding issues in that area. So there are ramps and stairways that'll take you up to the main entrance level. And in the future from there, that's where you'll go through the fare gates and then take the elevators and escalators or stairs up to the station platforms. Over the short term, most of the access is going to be by walking. Again, there'll be you'll be able to get dropped off or picked up on the curb in front of the station. I don't want to speak for the city, but I know that they're working on some bus rail integration plans. I'm not sure if they're going to have the bus stops there at the opening. In the future, when we do the next phase of the project, we're going to have a bus transit center with 8 bus bays, I believe, and a 1,600 stall parking garage. And that's all going to be accessed from the intersection at Waihona Street. So again, this is a very important station, key intermodal facility, mobility hub for the system, allows people to get up to Central Oahu. It will be connected with a ramp that'll come right off the H2 freeway, right into the transit center. And that's all in the progress and kind of the next phase. So thank you.
Thank you, Ryan. And I know what all you folks are thinking. For Dr. Tam to be involved with the project for nearly 12 years, let me go ahead and answer the question. Yes, he was 10 when he started working here at HART. I joke. Obviously, Ryan Tam looks young, and so I'm a little jealous that he's been on the project that long, but he has a great knowledge of exactly what is happening. But thank you to that Pearl City board member, Mr. Agard, for the question. We appreciate that. And I do know that he's right. In that Pearl City area, there are a lot of questions about that stop. And that's a stop that once that parking structure is built, you know, I think a lot of people really feel like that could be something that is going to be heavily used. I mean, with Central Oahu, the North Shore, being able to access that, that could be a very busy station in the very near future. Okay, another question coming in. This is from Alamoana Kakaako Neighborhood Board Member Bronson Kalaikai. Okay, when does HART anticipate handing control of the first phase over to the city for interim operations? And if I could bring in our expert, Bob Good. Bob, if you don't mind telling us when we believe that HART's going to be able to hand over the control for that first phase to the city for interim operation.
Thanks, Jai. Right now, we're planning, as we said a bit earlier, to start trial running in the April timeframe, mid-April, and that'll run for 90 days. So about the middle of July, hopefully everything goes well and as planned, but middle of July, we ought to finish up the trial running, and at that point, once we have secured the safety certification, we'll hand the system over to DTS. And at that point, they'll decide when they want to operate. But our plan is by middle of July to hand it over.
Thank you, Mr. Good. We appreciate that. And we also had a question that came in, Facebook question from Max Sheba. And Max, if you're listening, you might have heard. So the handover, heart planning, at least the middle of July. Then the important thing to know is when you're asking when's the public going to get to try out the rail. Well, once that is handed over, as Mr. Good said, once it's certified, then it becomes the Department of Transportation Services, the ball's in their court, if you will. So as far as when the public's going to get to go on and what that interim service will look like, that's something that the Department of Transportation Services will set. But as you heard Mr. Good saying, by the middle of July, we plan on having those trains certified and to be ready for interim service. Again, two different ways that you can reach out to us. If you want questions, you can put in that comment section on Facebook. Just enter any question you want. Also, even if you don't get a chance and you think of it later tonight, you think of it first thing tomorrow morning and you're wanting to have a question answered, feel free to email info@honolulutransit.org. That is monitored on a daily basis. So any question you might have, we're able to reach out to the expert in that particular area and get you answers, any answers that you may have. So even if you're not able to get it on tonight on our Facebook Live feed here, feel free to still send it to that email address because it will be answered and we can get, like we said, we can redirect that out to our very first and our very best experts as far as who can handle that and kind of whose kuleana that is. Okay, some more questions and answers. We appreciate you guys joining us tonight. Okay, we've got a comment coming in. And unfortunately, once I get a card handed to me, it comes closer. I have to have reading glasses. I'm not like Dr. Tam, I'm old. So here's what we got. Just a thanks from Tammy Akana.
To Tammy Akana.
To Tammy Akana. Thank you, Tammy Akana. We will reach out to you regarding, let's see, the pothole issue. And so we appreciate that. We have already got that. So thank you, Tammy Akana. And we will reach out about that pothole issue. And we understand that we appreciate your patience with us. I know that there's a lot of work that's gone on in some of these areas, and especially with some of the folks who live close by to some of the stations. We appreciate your patience. And with us testing now, and that's kind of why we brought you this tonight, is we want you to know that this dynamic testing is because they need to get this done. And so that 24/7 schedule is being maintained because they, as you could see from some of the presentation, especially with We Win, as far as integrating all these different systems that have to work together. So it takes a lot of burning in, as we had said earlier with Bob Beadle from Hitachi Rail Honolulu. You need to put miles on these vehicles and they need to be tested with all these different systems as well. So we appreciate the questions and all the great questions that were sent in tonight. So we thank you for that. Now, we really hope that you can help us out. We have a survey that we would love for you to take part in. As we said earlier, with this survey, we are able to sort of get an idea of what's important to you out in the community, what you want to know, some of the questions you may have, and it helps us focus, especially some of these presentations with COVID-19 and with the fact that we've kind of had to go virtual. It really does help us to know what you're thinking out there. It's really easy. Just go.honolulutransit.org/survey. So once again, go.honolulutransit.org/survey. And we would appreciate you reaching out and helping us out by taking that survey. We thank you very much. Or you can do this also. When you open your camera on your cell phone, just simply point the camera at the QR code, click the prompt on your phone, take the survey. QR codes are making things so much easier and really changing the way we order at restaurants now with COVID-19, the fact that, you know, it's going to be kind of funny. In 10 years' time, you'll never have remembered using an actual physical menu because you just simply do it this way. And so it makes things quite easy. It just means we're living on our phones, these smartphones these days. Wanted to tell you about a few different programs that we have in place that are out there for especially small business. You know, one of the big mantras for our business outreach is that we want to support small business, support business that's along the rail line. It is critical, especially these past 10, 11 months since COVID has been front and center, sort of on the front page on almost a daily basis. We have shop and dine on the line. And what this is, it's a free program that we offer to businesses. It's a discount program. So many of these businesses already have discounts in place. This just gives us an opportunity for free, no charge to them, to be able to present it in our social media, as well as online at shopanddineontheline.com. You see some of the signage that we're able to provide for them. And again, this is a really good deal for them because it is free to the businesses. And we're just, like we said, trying to really support small business. We've been telling you throughout the evening how you can stay connected with us here at Hart. There are a handful of different ways that you can reach out to be in touch with us. We have weekly traffic advisories that we post through a weekly e-blast. Of course, our website is HonoluluTransit.org. We have a number of different social media outreach that we do as far as YouTube, as far as on Facebook and Twitter. Then we have our rapid response. So want to let you know about the 24-hour project hotline. Super easy. It can be reached 808-566-2299. Or as we've been saying throughout the evening, the info at HonoluluTransit.org. Any inquiries that you might have, a lot of times folks are busy. Once you get to work, you maybe have a little bit of time and you can send out an email. That's another thing. And again, the social media as well. So we hope that you appreciated this presentation tonight. The dynamic train testing, it continues, and you will continue to see those trains out in the area. As Mr. Beadle said from Hitachi Rail Honolulu, please stay safe. I know that it's tempting to want to pull over, take a picture. As he said, in due time, we will be able to ride on these trains. Then you will be able to take shots that are much more memorable because you will have those beautiful views as the train is moving, video that you can take as well. So we just ask that you please stay safe and look ahead, not overhead. But we appreciate you joining us tonight. We'll continue to have these virtual community outreach meetings. As we said, we've kind of had to go indoors over the past 10 months or so because of the limitations as far as any sort of public presentation we can make. So this really is the best way for us to reach out to you guys and to make sure that we continue to answer any questions you may have, continue to be as transparent as we can as to where we stand on this project, whether it's construction, whether it's the train testing, all the different things that are going on out there. We want to keep you informed. So we will stay in touch with you. We definitely do that through our social media, and we do that as often as we can. And again, once we set that next sort of virtual meeting, we will let you know and keep you updated. Well, we hope, because it is quickly approaching, I want to wish everyone a very happy holidays, a Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year. And we will see you in the coming year, 2021. And as you heard tonight, there's a lot of exciting things that are going on here with the Honolulu Rail Project. We appreciate your attention tonight. We appreciate you tuning into us. Thank you. Have a wonderful night. Aloha, folks.